Welcome to the Teapot Reads. I'm the Teapot. This is what I'm currently reading, and I'm so happy to see you today. Hello, welcome, welcome, welcome. This is another Barnes & Noble video. I like doing these videos. People seem to really like watching them, and I thought it'd be really interesting to do like a day in the life of a Barnes & Noble bookseller. Now, this isn't like a vloggy day in the life, just because I'm not comfortable filming at work. I also don't think it would be okay. You'd have to get like permission from a lot of employees and customers that I just think would be really difficult. So I'm just going to walk you through what a typical day in the life work looks like. I am filming in a new location. The lighting here is just better. I thought it would be kind of interesting to shake it up and try it here. I'm also going to be probably looking down a lot because I have a script, because I basically took several days of work and condensed it into a script of what a typical very busy day looks like, and I don't want to miss something, so I have a little teleprompter thing going on my computer, so if I keep looking down, that is what's going on. I'm also drinking tea. So everyday book selling kind of has things that are very similar. There isn't much variety day to day. The details might change. Like I said, this is a composite of about 12 different days of work. I made lists every day of what I had done that day, and I have broken it down into what one very busy Tuesday would look like. And I chose Tuesday. Coincidentally, I'm filming this on a Tuesday, but I chose Tuesday because Tuesdays are my favorite day to work, at least to work an opening shift. It is new book release day. It is a very exciting day. A lot of fun things get done on Tuesdays. So I did include some things that aren't always super typical, but do happen, and I wanted to include them. I also broke the day down into hours. It's not like a strictly this is what happens every hour, except for a couple circumstances, which you'll see at the very beginning. I did this just to help guide the flow of this video, but as I do kind of mention, things, especially customer service work, you can't really plan when customers are going to need certain things, so a lot of these just happen throughout the day. So 8 a.m. open the store for the employees. We have about 2 hours to get work done before customers start coming in, but it is Tuesday, so it is new book release day, which means we take a lot of time to set up the new books, put them in places where they're going to sell best, make sure they are on display, make sure we have a good idea of what is going to be popular, so that when customers do come in, not just on Tuesday, but throughout the week, we can be like, I know exactly where that book is. It impresses the customers a lot. But also it's good for us. It helps us not look embarrassing. And that happens sometimes. If you don't know where a book is, it can be kind of embarrassing to be like, oh, this popular book, I have no idea where it is. Like, you should know where the James Pattersons are. You should know where the Leigh Bardugo's are. You know, the things that people are asking for, you should know where they are. And Tuesday is when we pick where they're going to be. There is obviously guidance. There's a bestseller bay. There's tables that we use for new releases, you know, but it is kind of a fun and important thing to do. When I'm the senior bookseller on the floor, that means that at 8 a.m. after having like a quick little meeting with my team, I go create the daily schedule, which is like the schedule of breaks and everything, and then I clean the bathrooms. We do have a cleaning crew. They don't come in every day of the week, so the senior booksellers on the floor have to do it whatever days they aren't doing it. It's just cleaning the bathrooms. It doesn't take that long, maybe like half an hour, as long as everything's okay. I also check the emails, the calendar, and any notes that might have been left to see if there's anything pressing that needs to be done ASAP, and I take care of that. Some things can be pushed a little later till closer to opening. If that's the case, like putting things out on display are the most important. Things that might be in the calendar, like events, could be like preparing for a sale or taking off something defective. This happens a lot with greeting cards for some reason. They just like misprint the greeting cards. Like, it'll be a birthday card that makes no sense, kind of thing. So by 9 o'clock, I finished up all this other stuff. People on the floor have started really getting around to putting things up. Depending on the day, there are going to be more books or there are going to be less books. Not all the time does the bestseller list change, but sometimes it changes drastically. So I go out, and I mean, they've probably done a pretty good job at that point, and I help finish up putting all the new books out. If they have any questions, I help with that. And then it's really about shelving the books that we had to move or take off, or that we had overstock of. This actually takes slightly longer because sometimes you'll have a lot of overstock and you just don't have anywhere directly to put it, and then it does have to go in the back. It's kind of sad to do that because you know, if it's not on the floor, it can't sell. You should keep at least one copy, if not more than one copy, of every title on the floor. But sometimes you have like 30 copies and you have to put them all on the shelves in the back room. It's very sad to me. The other thing you do in the morning is work on SFS and BOPIS. Those are two different types of online orders that people place. A lot of times if they're there in the morning, it means it was placed overnight and not that it was left from the day before. We do try to get on top of them within like an hour or so of them being placed, as long as that is meaningful. Throughout the day, I check to make sure that like there isn't a new order that's been placed. It's really easy to check every time you log onto the computer, which is something that you do multiple times because that's how you track to see if we have a book, where a book might be, if we can order the book. It'll say in like the top corner whether there are new orders to take care of. So it's very convenient, very nice, and it is something that you should and you do check multiple times a day. And really just filling these orders means finding them. Most of the time it's pretty easy, very self-explanatory stuff, but especially with SFS, a lot of times it's very obscure items, so sometimes you need like three sets of eyes to look for it. And not to toot my own horn, but I'm very good at finding obscure things in the store. So 10 a.m., time to open the store. Some customers get there bright and early. They'll be waiting outside the store. A lot of times, those are the customers that are there for sports cards, although our regular sports cards and Pokemon cards, our trading card people, they know at this point that our shipments don't come before we open, so the items probably won't be out until like a little later in the day. But you know, sometimes they're there very early to see what we have. Also, a lot of times early morning customers are there for coffee at the cafe. They'll do a little shopping, or they're very focused people who go in and get what they need to get and then leave. But 10 a.m., customers are here. This is when customer service kicks into gear. And this is kind of the stuff that's going, what I'm going to be doing for the next several hours. And these are the things that are regularly happening. So obviously helping customers find books, whether that means ordering it or like finding it in the store, answering the phones and helping customers on the other line. Sometimes it's other stores calling to see if we can help their customer. There's a lot of communication and teamwork that happens in all the stores. There are store cell phones. I carry one around with me. A lot of times I use it as a sort of canary just to let me know that the store phone is ringing, because I don't love talking on the store cell phone. But if I can't get to the landline, I do use the cell phone to answer. The sound quality just isn't as good, so I don't like using it. Nook support is another thing we do. So that's one of the perks of buying a Nook, and this is not me like pitching it to you, but one of the supports of buying a Nook is that you could come into a store and we can help you with it. It's a very intuitive device, and at this point I've helped a lot of people with their Nooks that I can help most issues. If we can't help, we call someone who can, or we replace it if it's under warranty. Filling tables is another big thing. So making sure tables look full, look shoppable, have the proper stickers on them, have the proper types of titles on them. The idea is that every table does kind of have a theme, whether or not it's a like a large theme or a small theme, it depends on the table. The idea is to get as many types of books for that theme to cater to as many readers as you can. So if you have a mystery table, maybe you want some hard-boiled detective mysteries and some cozy mysteries. You know, you want to kind of mix because you want to appeal to everyone. One of my favorite tables to shelve is a book talk table, which I'm going to talk about slightly in a little bit. Shelving the carts. This is stuff left over from the day before or stuff that we've just received in today that needs to get out on the floor. I love shelving new books, but it's super distracting. A lot of times I'll take a little bit extra time to read some of the more interesting books. I consider this kind of like research, and it is actually really helpful. There have been multiple times in the many times actually at work where people have asked for obscure books where I'm like, I know that book because I took the time to read it and look at it a little bit. Also bumpering and organizing shelves. This just, again, kind of like filling tables, makes the store look very shoppable, very clean, very neat. It's a bit time consuming if someone hasn't been shelving and keeping an eye on the category, but if everyone is kind of on top of their game, it's not hard at all. It's very easy. One section that has to be shelved and bumpered and organized like every day is manga. We actually do it like twice a day. It's a very shopped section. Also writing shelf talkers for books I've read or books that I've heard good things about and want to promote, or there's another book by the author coming out. There's a lot of reasons to write shelf talkers. I always sign my name on it if it is something I've personally read and am supporting. I don't do this every day. It's something that I don't have time for every day, but I like to do it. It's a lot of fun. It's like mini flash reviews, and they work really, really well. Face outs on shelves will sell books really well. And shelf talkers will sell books really well. So it's kind of important to be on top of that and make sure there are a proper amount of shelf talkers out in the store. Some sections get a lot less loved than others, but you know, it's our job as booksellers to make sure all customers are catered to and all sections of the store have appealing books for everybody. So 11 a.m. is break time. In Illinois, I don't know about other states' labor laws, but in Illinois, if you work, I believe it's more than 4.5 hours, you get a 15-minute unpaid break. If you work more than 8.5 hours, you get 2 15-minute breaks. So I typically work between 8 and 8.5 hours, so that's 1 or 2 15-minute breaks plus a unpaid lunch. So today we're gonna do like an 8.5-hour shift. So yes, it's like my first break time. 12 a.m. Assuming the store is not super busy and there are enough employees to make sure shelving and cleaning and filling tables is all being completed, I like to work on shortlisting books. Shortlisting, let me explain it real quick. Shortlisting is ordering books into the store that we need or that I think would sell well. You have to be very careful and you do have to justify what you're shortlisting and you shouldn't go overboard. For example, I shortlisted in 10 copies, I think it was 10, it might only have been 5, copies of Strange the Dreamer. Oh my god, I can't believe I blanked on the title. I shortlisted 5 copies of Strange the Dreamer because I could hand sell it. It sold well, so I shortlisted more. And at this point, it sells pretty well in our store and I don't need to hand sell it. You know, it's something that I thought would sell well, it's something I knew I could sell, so I shortlisted it in. Another area where I shortlist a lot is manga. We have a lot of series that we have like the first, second, third, and then like the 25th, the 24th, the 26th, and those, the first three, and then the later ones sell really well, but we're missing the middle, so to kind of fill that out, I shortlist those titles. They need to be shortlisted and they don't just automatically replenish because we hadn't had those titles in the store before. So you can't go overboard, you have to be really careful or you'll have a lot of dead stock in your store. But if you have a good idea of what's going on, it's a lot of fun. There is someone on the other end who will sometimes be like, why did you shortlist so many? Or will kind of keep you in line. But it's really helpful and it's a really great tool. And it's a lot of fun to be like, I could sell this book, I'm gonna order it in. Or, hey, customers really like these books about weather, I'm gonna order some more in. And it's so rewarding when you see those books selling. I shortlist not just a lot for manga, but a lot for the cozy mystery section because I've had customers complain about our poor selection and also the science fiction and fantasy section. I read a lot of sci-fi fantasy. Obviously, if you're watching this channel, you know I read a lot of sci-fi fantasy. Our store does not have a huge sci-fi fantasy readership, but we have a big enough one that we should be catering to it. There were a lot of series missing titles. There were a lot of series that just weren't present that I know are really popular, really beloved. There are some that I was like, look, if I, a serious sci-fi fantasy reader, came into the store, I would be disappointed not to see this author on the shelf. So I've been working on keeping that section organized, filled, clean, up to date with everything. I also love shortlisting for the book talk table. So we do have a giant book talk TikTok table up at the front of the store. The titles on here, some of them are like perennial. They'll always sell when they're on there. Other titles on there just don't. And you have to stay current. And it is like the fun little game I play of like shortlisting in new titles that I see getting big. Like lately I've been doing some Atessa Mashfe books because they've been getting big and they sell off the table, and I had to take off like Ember in the Ashes because it wasn't really selling anymore. So it's like this fun little game of saying what's selling, what are people reading, what do people want to read more of, what is actually popular on TikTok. And I do spend a lot of my free time on TikTok, on BookTok, so I do have a good idea of what's on there. I'm not the only one shortlisting, I should say that. Like, everyone in the store kind of has a hand in it, and there are some of us who do a lot more than others, but in my typical day I do like to do some shortlisting. So 1 p.m. we're gonna just call this lunch break. I did want to say I do on my lunch breaks tend to do a lot of reading. If I get all three of my breaks and I spend all three breaks reading, I do get about 50 pages done at work, which is a nice number. If there's someone else in the break room, I do like to talk. We talk on the floor, but you know, you can have better conversations when you're not surrounded by customers. So it is always a delight when you get the chance to kind of talk on your lunch break. And a lot of times, I'm not gonna lie, we talk about books. That is a big topic just at the store in general. All of us are big book readers. So 2 p.m., obviously still doing customer service stuff. It's later in the day. There are some other things that are regularly happening besides customer service, and that is doing projects. I kind of mentioned it earlier, doing important projects in the calendar. So, like I said, prepping for a sale, taking off something that is defective from the shelves. Sometimes they're multi-day investments. Lately, we have been working on redoing our entire gift department, and that means taking down fixtures, putting up new fixtures, reorganizing, making things look pretty, making the shelves seem cohesive, making sure everything is where it is supposed to be. It has been a multi-day investment, and we've had to move around so many things and build so many fixtures and tables, and it's probably not going to be done until mid next week just because of how much work needs to be done. So yeah, sometimes there are projects like this that are really, really busy, but other times they're like really easy, like, oh, just sticker this BTS album, it's 20% off for the next 2 weeks. So, you know, it kind of varies, but projects, they happen, I would say, every 1 out of 3 days, there's at least a project, and it just varies. And actually, that's not fair, because most days that there are projects, there are big projects, like, or a lot of projects, but not every day has something on the calendar necessarily. So 3 p.m., time for my other 15 minute. We are getting so close to the end of the day, and 4 p.m., finally my day is winding to a close. Like I said, I love opening on Tuesdays. Not only do I get to put the books out, but I get to leave a little earlier than I do most days. Retail is really repetitive, so at 4 p.m., I'm still doing a lot of things I was doing at 10 a.m. There are a couple things that shake it up, like having meetings. I've had a couple of those recently. They're fun, but they're a nice like reprieve from the store, but they're also like weird to have meetings during the retail job. I do also sometimes help with the store social media. I'm really close with the person who does the store social media regularly, so if she can't get to it, I try to help out. 4:30 p.m. and I am leaving. It is time to clock out for the day. I'm probably going to pick myself up some food on the way home or eat out there because it has been a long day. But I'm also probably going to stop and shop for some books before I leave. Let's be honest, that's just kind of how I roll. It's throughout the day, I didn't mention this, but I do tend to just like, if something is really interesting, I will stuff it to the side, and then at the end of the day, go through it and decide if I want to buy any, and then I'll just shelve the ones I don't want to buy. But yeah, that is a regular day. That is a typical day of working at Barnes & Noble and book selling. I feel like I spoke really quickly. I hope it wasn't overwhelming. I just wanted to get it all out. And there is so much that happens at work every day. A lot of fun. Like I said in every Barnes & Noble video I make, I love working at Barnes & Noble. It is the most fulfilling job I've had. It's a great place to work. I wouldn't trade it for anything. If you have more questions about it, I do have 2 other videos I've done about Barnes & Noble. I have 10 things you may not have known about working at Barnes & Noble and quirky things that happen at Barnes & Noble. I am planning to do at least 1 more video in this like Barnes & Noble series. But after that, I probably am gonna let it be unless people have specific things they wanna know more about working at the store, which if you do, I can probably answer it down below. So do not be afraid to ask me questions about it. I am going to be very pro company though. So, I mean, if you're looking for some tea, I don't have that much tea about it. But that is it for me today. That is it for me. If you liked this video, if you wanna see more videos like this, please subscribe. I post once a week. Lately, I've been posting more than once a week, all bookish content all the time. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for being here. I hope this video finds you well. If it is cold where you're at, I hope you're staying warm. If it is warm where you're at, I hope you're staying comfortable. And most of all, I hope you're reading a great book. I will see you next time. Bye.